Your Natchez History Minute is brought to you by Natchez National Historical Park.
On this day, April 7th, 1864, Douglas Rivers, who lived at a house called the Wigwam, wrote a letter to General Marcellus Monroe Crocker, the Union Commandant of the Natchez District. Rivers and other homeowners whose houses lay within Fort McPherson were being evicted. As a federal fortification neared completion, General William T. Sherman had issued an order that anyone living behind Union lines would have to vacate their houses. The homeowners, however, were to be compensated in gold, and Rivers reminded Crocker that his house had been appraised for $9,600. From his letter, it is clear that Rivers doubts whether or not he will be compensated. "Is there any chance of getting pay?" he asked Crocker. Although the order for his exit had been issued, but not yet sent or served on him, Rivers had already rented the suburban estate of Samuel Davis, which lay just outside enemy lines. Natchez planters were extremely fond of General Crocker, who allowed them, after they had taken the oath of allegiance to the United States government, to sell their cotton on the open market. Rivers and his fellow Natchezians, however, detested General James Tuttle, the man who succeeded Crocker as commandant. In his letter, Rivers referred to Tuttle as the new king who now rules over the military Israel of Natchez, who knows not Joseph. After the Rivers left the wigwam, the house was used as a staff and officers' quarters for the Union Army.
We are Cindy and Joe Ming, present owners of the wigwam, and this has been your Natchez History Minute.